And the latest is that we continue with the extensive search for Mr. Caracamo. No signs as yet, but there's high hopes, you know. If he's in the area, we will find him. Mr. Caracamo, as you know, he was wearing a blue company coverall, helmet, gloves, glasses, all necessary safety gear for the job. We have extended the search in about 10 mile radius from Freetown, Cebuon area. We have eight company discovery size crews. We still have the police department, the BDF, and the Hatteville community at large assisting in this endeavor. It's a really stressful endeavor, and we still have high hopes that we are going to find Mr. Caracamo, one way or the other, you know. And to this point, we have no signs of it, you know. We can't find a glass, his safety glasses, his even a hard hat, his yellow hard hat he was wearing, you know, in the event that something had occurred to him. And we have high hopes that if he is out there, we will find him with everything on. And the entire public is out there at large trying to assist. I want to thank everybody. And Wakuzo over there, we are getting very tired, and because we're up there till about 6-7 in the evening, you know, I'm going to get stuck. Our crews are out there from 5 in the morning trying to locate our search crew.
Mr. Caracamo, in terms of trying to locate him, the lay of the land, so to speak, the terrain is partly Pine Ridge, and it's partly savanna and jungle, I would want to say.
The area he was presently working on, the area is presently flat, okay? A little bit of potholes here and there, the extreme of the line, because we were working south of the Freetown, Cebuon. So the line extends about 8 kilometers to the end of the line from where we were working. And we had finished laying out all our recording material online. So basically, our way out would be following the pin flags and following the recording material on the line, recording cable.